When we think of doctors, we see people who solve problems and quickly spring into action to save people's lives. But what haven't you seen a doctor do? How about spin records at a club or release a festive Christmas album? You may think of doctors as having a one-track mind, but the most successful ones actually have a variety of talents. Viewpoints spoke with two physicians who de-stress through different interests, and they're not alone.
I feel like a lot of physicians have multifaceted interests. When I first started medical school, some of my classmates studied hieroglyphics, the computer programming, and so I was very impressed with my class at Boston University School of Medicine. You know, everyone's very diverse and had diverse interests.
That's Dr. Thomas Oden, an adult psychiatrist who specializes in forensic psychiatry. If you've ever watched an episode of CSI, SVU, or any other crime show, forensic psychiatrists are the expert doctors who testify to a person's mental capabilities. It can be a taxing job, but that isn't Dr. Oden's only place of employment. If you live in Atlanta, you can catch him at the club spinning records as a very successful DJ. He says this affinity towards mixing beats started during his medical training.
When I went to medical school at Boston University School of Medicine, I began to realize, okay, I need to have more outlets. I first started by playing the bass guitar, but then I noticed that during high anxiety, during test periods of time, I would not practice as much, and I just felt the skill set kind of like not really being to where I wanted it to be. And then I saw DJing as an opportunity to really get back into music, actually relate to people a bit more, to use those skill sets and observations in a more entertaining and social context.
Dr. Oden goes by the stage name DJ Diagnosis as a nod to his double life. His music is full of R&B soulful vibes, which in part can be traced back to his New Orleans roots.
Lost in the heat of it all.
What do you think? Whether it's your style or not, Dr. Oden says the visible enjoyment that some listeners get out of his music and performances is one of the most rewarding parts of his funky side gig.
This allowed me an opportunity to just use everything I had learned, you know, like you're using aspects of psychology, you're using aspects of music theory, and it all ties together pretty well when you're looking at a crowd of people and you're trying to figure out what they want to hear and you're seeing the crowd's movement. You know, showcasing that they actually like what you're playing and you're keeping it going. You may see different, you know, shifts in energy.
Dr. Oden isn't the only musician with an MD who has witnessed the infectious power of music. Dr. James Webb, a radiologist in Tulsa, Oklahoma, also happens to be a rising country artist who sings for his own health and to lift the spirits of his listeners.
There's a lot of power of the mind that we haven't really learned how it works, much less how to harness it. I think that comes into play in things like general health and in disease and probably in cancer and a lot of these other issues that we're just starting to look at. So I think one of the main things in music, obviously it heals the spirit, the human spirit, and can be uplifting to the soul, if you want to call it that. And I think that might, in 100 years or 200 years, that might be what we're looking back, and that's why music is so powerful for people. It may be this mind-body connection that, you know, we haven't really elucidated yet.
Webb has released a number of very successful country tracks, including the songs Now We're Getting Somewhere and American Beauty. But take a listen to his latest hit called April May, which is a relaxing, down-country love ballad.
She's got a hold on this old heart that may never go away. And I won't start some long slow march to a June wedding day. No woman's ever made me stay, but I'm thinking April May.
As the 2019 holiday season gets underway, what advice does Webb have for his fellow medical professionals working in the field? Treat more than just a patient's body. take time to also brighten their spirits through some small act of kindness.
A lot of times people, scientists and doctors, especially scientists, are quick to dismiss spiritual things or things that we can't see. But we know that when people focus on a negative thought or get obsessed with that, some negative things, that can certainly lead to specific types of psychiatric problems or just depression or moods. And conversely, we know that when people that have more of a positive attitude generally tend to do better than people that have, I'm concerned that I'm going to die from this, you know.
Webb himself is familiar with the power of a positive mindset. Keep in mind, becoming a doctor isn't an easy task, and neither is the touring musician lifestyle. But through resilience and faith, Webb has been able to achieve both. He says it definitely wasn't a walk in the park, but the journey is really what shapes you.
Medical school and residency is just the abuse that we take during that time. It's really just like indentured servanthood. I remember being a little kid and learning about being an indentured servant to come to America and thought, well, that'd be crazy. Why would anybody want to be a slave for 5 years or whatever? And now I kind of, as an adult, I can understand why somebody would do that to have an opportunity to live in this country. And the whole medical school residency, you're really not getting paid. You're certainly not getting paid a living wage, even as a resident. So there's a lot of difficulty. It takes a lot of wherewithal and long-term commitment to your goal, even just to get through that. But at the same time, I think it also hones your will and your goals and makes you have to be sure that this is what you want to do.
Perhaps just as difficult as putting on a white coat is being able to juggle music with medicine on a day-to-day basis. Dr. Oden can testify to both challenges.
The height of my DJing occurred during my residency in psychiatry. Oftentimes, I would DJ for a few days, followed by being on call for 24 hours in the ER. And I loved it. I never saw it necessarily being a conflict, but it definitely took a lot of energy to do both. Oftentimes, depending on the type of setting that you're performing at as a DJ, you know, you could be the first person at the venue, the last person to leave. And that can definitely cause wear and tear in your body in different ways, sleep deprivation. And so I've had to be, you know, over time, more calculative in what opportunities I will take on, because I know that my primary duty is to serve the patients that I'm taking care of.
Both Dr. Oden and Dr. Webb are living these double lives in hopes of changing a lot more than people's playlists. They hope to inspire others to live more purposeful lives.
If you find a job that you love, you never work a day in your life. And I'm extremely grateful and hashtag blessed is kind of a joke these days, but really, I mean, without going through life with gratitude, it's kind of hard to go through this modern life, I think. And I'm really lucky to be able to have two jobs where I can make a difference and where I'm really called in love and enjoy and find a great deal of fulfillment.
Whether these two are in the hospital or in the recording studio, they're not alone in juggling two completely different passions. Many doctors take up more than you may assume. To find out more about Dr. Thomas Oden and Dr. James Webb, and to listen to more of their music, visit viewpointsradio.org. This segment is written and produced by Annie Kroll. Studio production by Jason Dickey. I'm Marty Peterson.
Viewpoints returns in just a moment.
About 27 million people in the United States have chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, or COPD. COPD is treatable, yet half of flare-ups are never reported to physicians, suggesting that patients are not seeking appropriate care. There are 1.2 million COPD hospital admissions each year, and one in four patients hospitalized for a COPD flare-up die within a year. Dr. David Menino is a respiratory medical expert at GSK.
It is important to act before COPD progresses. Flare-ups should be treated early on before the condition worsens. Having one COPD flare-up increases the risk of having another, and studies have shown each flare-up can cause more lung damage. You don't have to settle with symptoms that interfere with your daily routine. If you continue to experience COPD symptoms, speak with your doctor about what more can be done to manage them.
Dr. Menino says studies demonstrate that early treatment brings improvement in lung function, breathlessness, and quality of life. Find out more at COPD.com.
It's National Alzheimer's Disease Awareness Month, as well as National Family Caregivers Month. The two go together, since there are more than 16 million families and friends in the U.S. caring for someone with Alzheimer's. According to the Alzheimer's Association, 4 out of 5 caregivers say they'd like more support in providing care, especially from their families, yet 39% haven't engaged others in caregiving tasks. Ruth Drew, Director of Information and Support Services for the Alzheimer's Association, has suggestions on ways to help.
Make a standing appointment to give the caregiver a break so they can run errands or go to a support group. Caregivers often feel isolated or alone, so check in with a phone call or stop by for a visit. And when you offer support, be specific. Say, I'm going to the store, what do you need, rather than call me if you need anything.
People overwhelmingly agree caregiving for someone with Alzheimer's should be a group effort. Find more tips and resources for caregivers at alz.org.
And that's Viewpoints for this week. Viewpoints is a production of MediaTracks Communications. Follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram to learn more about upcoming shows. And find a library of past programs on Apple Podcasts, Google Play, and Spotify. Plus, you'll always find previous segments and more information about our guests at viewpointsradio.org. Join us again next week for another edition of Viewpoints. Coming up next week...
It was a dreadful disease, a hemorrhagic fever that killed quite gruesomely.
The illnesses workers faced while building the Panama Canal. Then...
There's a lot of things that we can learn in this country that are different overseas.
The importance of keeping a global perspective on learning. I'm Marty Peterson.
And I'm Gary Price. These stories in depth on your public affairs magazine, Viewpoints.